The Celtics have outscored Detroit 7-0 on second chance points. Normally, that's been dominated by the Pistons. Thomas penetrating, dishes to Mahorn.
Read the defense perfectly, Dick.
Dennis Johnson is wide open. Question is how fast Dumars can get to him. Parrish with a turnaround. Parrish was the Celtics' leading scorer in the series before yesterday. He only scored a couple of points and one hit. And Ricky Mahorn gets into the act, and now you talk about the diversification of the Pistons. Mahorn takes the shot from the free throw line and hits. We apologize for brief transmission problem. You didn't miss much. Rodman and Sally, who were really kind of skittery as we used yesterday in the games in Boston, seemed to settle down and get back to their high-flying ways yesterday in game three.
Well, they can play. They may be inexperienced in playoff competition, but they will put run into this ball club, and I don't think the Pistons are using it very effectively in this quarter. Well, Robert Parrish is out, and they put Darren Day at that forward spot in hopes that they can get some fast breaks to Celtics.
So McHale is playing the center position now for Boston. Laimbeer buries another one. No stopping Bill Laimbeer. He has 18 points and picks off a pass.
A poor pass by Larry Bird.
Mahorn.
And picking out the right matchups to go to Bird in the low post.
Steal. And Thomas is fouled by Danny Ames. And this place is rocking.
Laimbeer goes right to the glass.
Vincent gets it into McHale. Laimbeer. Misses a three, and Fred Roberts misses, and a foul against the Pistons. Mahorn misses the inside shot, and the Celtics with Ames pushing it up goes the distance, blocked by Rodman, and a 4-on-2 for Detroit. And Mahorn and Dave. Dick Versace, Chuck Daly's assistants, have to get Mahorn away from Day, who commits the foul. And the cheerleader, Rodman. You better not be too premature with the number one.
Let's watch what happens here as Mahorn takes it and just walks up, and Day just gave him a push, which was really not deserved, I don't think. I don't know where that came from. And Mahorn reacts. But that's understandable. He doesn't have all the experience in the world.
The lead is 21. Mahorn. Chuck Daly can relax the rest of this game.
I don't know why Kevin McHale is still in this ball game.
The all-time Piston playoff high, 133, and Mahorn leaves the game. in 30 minutes for Vinny Johnson. And a foul against Tony Campbell.